Hey, what is up, programmers? Eric here, and in today's video, I'm going to show you GitHub Copilot CLI. GitHub Copilot CLI is a command line tool that allows you to take natural language and then convert that natural language into a shell command, a git command, or a GitHub CLI command. And it's able to do this because it is powered by GitHub Copilot behind the scenes. All you have to do is install it into your terminal, and then you can start using it. If you haven't caught any of my past videos, I have several videos talking about GitHub Copilot, GitHub Copilot Labs, GitHub Copilot X, and Chat. And if you want to sign up for this one, you'll have to go and sign up for it via the GitHub Copilot X suite of tools. And you should find a link below to that, to the signup page, and also provide a couple links to previous videos touching on GitHub Copilot. But let's stop talking about it and let's dive in and see how it works. First things first, if you manage to get onto the technical preview for GitHub Copilot CLI, or maybe now it's fully released, the first thing you're going to want to do is go to npm.js and search for GitHub Copilot CLI, and you'll need to install this on your system. NPM is a hard dependency, so you will need to have NPM installed. If you follow the guide, you will easily install this by globally installing NPM, authenticating with GitHub Copilot CLI, and then finally adding it to your shell's profile. So your Z shell RC or your bash RC or whatever other system you're using. Now let's go over the three commands you'll be using with GitHub Copilot CLI and how to use them. The first one is the double ?? Command, and this will convert your natural language into a shell command. So if I wanted to change to the source directory, it'll go ask GitHub Copilot and then return back the command that would achieve that objective. Now let's review what this UI is doing. The first thing you'll see is the command itself. This is the command that it will suggest for you to do. After that, it'll explain what each component of the command does. CD is used for changing the directory. Source is the name of the directory you want to change to. It's important to review each step of these commands to make sure that they make sense. Even though GitHub Copilot is doing a very convincing answer for you, you need to double check because it could be using the wrong command for the wrong system. So it's essential that you go through each step and ensure that it makes sense to you also. And the last thing right here is to run this command, revise this query, or cancel. Let's cancel for now. Another tip that I have is you might want to go and ask the GitHub CLI, how do I change to the source directory with a ?? Because, you know, that's proper grammar, but that won't work. The ?? Is a special operator. So avoid using ?, even though it is a question, don't put a ?? In there. You'll learn the hard way eventually because you'll just get an error straight out. The next command that we'll cover is the ?? Git command. And the ?? Git command is for all your Git related natural language requests. So how do I push to develop? Oops, we did the ?? Operator again. Let's remove that and let's ask it again. So the general question is, how do I push to develop? And it will go and generate an answer for you. In this case, it's git push origin develop. It gives us an explanation of what git push is. It's used to push local commits to a remote repository. Origin specifies the remote repository, and develop specifies the branch to push to. Remember, review what it is telling you. And then the last command is GitHub ?? And this is for the GitHub CLI tool. The GitHub CLI tool is a special command line tool that GitHub developed that allows you to interact with your repositories and do a bunch of different stuff to manage things. So if I want to see the open issues for this repository, And this tells you how to do it. Git issues list, state open. Let's go ahead and try running this command. And it confirms to you, just in case you accidentally click enter, that are you sure you want to run this command in the shell? Click yes, and then it'll go and run that command. And in this case, my ChatGPT playground has no issues because it's my own repo. I don't have anything here. But we can start getting a little bit more advanced with these. So it's like, yeah, we did some trivial stuff, but let's get into a little bit more juicier stuff. Most of the time when I'm doing programming, I'm mostly interacting with Git and trying to do more difficult things with Git. Let's ask Git, I want to get the last three commits from last week. And it says, suggesting Git log since 1 week ago, one line and three. Let's break down what that is because I'm not familiar with this. So Git log, I'm familiar with. That's to list the commits. Since specifies that we only want the commits from last week. One line specifies that we only want the commit message. So in case you have the commit message with description, it only gives you one line. And three specifies that we only want the last three commits. Let's see what happens. Let's run this command. And we have our commits. All right, let's try something a little juicier. Let's see. Let's ask GitHub, I want to rebase my branch with master, but I only want to rebase the last five commits. So this one's a little bit more complex. This one's getting a little bit more juicy. Let's see what happens. And it's suggesting git rebase I head tilde five. Let's check the breakdown of what it's saying. So git rebase is used to rebase the branch on top of another branch. Cool. I specify that we want to interactively edit the rebase. And then tilde five specifies that we want to rebase the last five commits. That's looking pretty solid. Let's go ahead and cancel that. I'm not ready to do a rebase just yet. Now let's try using the question mark command, AKA natural language, to generate a shell command to find the largest file in the current directory or the child directory. So let's try to do that. I want to find the largest file in the current or child directories. Let's see how it goes. Find, period, type F, execute. Now that is a juicy command. Let's see what it's telling us about. Find is used to find a list of files. Type F specifies that we only want a list of files, not folders. Execute with the curly braces plus executes the command for each file with the file name as the last argument. DU-SH is used to compute the size of a file. Dash S, and we're breaking it down even further. Dash S means that we only want the size of the file, not the size of the folder containing it. H means that we want the size in human readable format. Sort dash RH sorts the list of files by size in reverse order. And then we get a breakdown again. Dash R means we want to sort in reverse order. Dash H means we want to sort by human readable size again. And then head dash N5 selects the first five lines of the list. Let's see what happens if we try to execute this command. Are we sure we want to execute? Yes. Oops, it looks like GitHub Copilot gave us a bad command. Looking at the error, it looks like DU has an invalid option of S in here. And we get an error message saying what the valid options are. And it looks like capital S isn't in there. We do have a lowercase s, but not a capital S. And this gets into the key point about using GitHub Copilot CLI, just like with using GitHub Copilot or using something even like Stack Overflow, is that it's not going to be right all the time. There's assumptions made about your system. There's assumptions made about the version of the tools that you're using, because GitHub Copilot only has knowledge up to a certain point and is making hard assumptions about your system. The commands might not necessarily work. So it's imperative that when it gives you a suggestion, maybe you should go and look up the commands that it's going to run to ensure that what it is suggesting is a good idea or it is valid. Don't just go and have it run commands that you're not familiar with. In this case, the du command was new to me. I should have went and go and looked it up real quick to make sure that du-sh is valid stuff. The other commands that we would related to Git, those ones are commands that I do on a fairly regular basis. So I was comfortable with knowing that those commands were correct. So always vet commands that you're not familiar with and making sure that they look good, because in this case, we got an error, but in other cases, we can accidentally delete entire directories or worse. And there you go. That's how you use GitHub Copilot CLI. To recap the commands that we can do, we can use the ?? Operator to use natural language to generate shell commands. We can use ?? Git command to generate Git related commands using natural language. And then also the ?? GH command if we want to use the GitHub CLI tool to manage different things with our GitHub repo. There are limitations to watch out for. The first one being is it's not free. You got to pay for it. In order to use it, you're going to have an existing GitHub Copilot subscription. So not free. The code that it generates could be wrong. So you need to make sure to review everything it does and check it for errors. Don't just blindly let it execute things. It is dependent on the internet. You can't do this offline. You need to be connected to the internet. And because it's connected to the internet, it could be slow too. So if you have a very poor connection, you can't reliably get an answer back in time. The next one is that it could be limited. It might not know how to answer your question. GitHub Copilot is dependent on the large language model that it was trained on. So if there is new CLI tools that were just released, or you know, you're trying to do something very unique, it might not have an answer for you. So you can't rely on it 100% of the time. But with these things in mind, GitHub Copilot CLI is still a great tool in your toolkit to help you develop faster, because now you don't have to go and searching for stuff. It can help you by you trying to explain things and yet generating code. Just double check what it generates. If you're interested in trying out GitHub Copilot CLI, then remember you have to go over to the GitHub Copilot X website and go and sign up for it there and join the wait list. There's a lot of people that sign up for this service, so I don't know how long it's going to be, but if you're interested, might as well go and sign up and see if you can get in eventually. And that's it. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit that subscribe button and hit the bell to get notifications about future videos. I'm Eric, and thanks for watching. Peace.